So children, there are is in Uttarakhand. Yes. Now children, today as you must have seen in the morning, first period, when your Hindi ma'am took, she told everything about Uttarakhand, about the poets and the writers of Uttarakhand, isn't it? So today in social studies, we will be learning about the Uttarakhand only, but about their culture, their customs of Uttarakhand, isn't it? So isn't it very beautiful to know something new about our country, about any different state? Isn't it? Are you feeling good? Yes, children? Huh? Are you feeling good? So today we will be going to a virtual tour to Uttarakhand. So in social studies, as we learn everything about the culture, the customs and all, so we will be learning the culture and customs of Uttarakhand. Now as each state of India, our India is only having so many cultures and customs. So there are so many. So even if you want to come to the Karnataka, when you come to go to the Maharashtra, when you go to any other state also, you will see lots and lots of customs and culture. They vary from state to state, isn't it? Now, when you come down to Karnataka, what are the culture and customs here we follow is? Huh. Anything else? Anything else? Now we have our own culture and all means now what culture we follow here in Karnataka? Can anybody tell me something about the culture of Karnataka? Okay, I'll give you one example of Kerala. Now in Kerala, they do their festivals. You know, they have one typical sari of their off-white with golden border, isn't it? So they wear that sari on Onam. Onam is their festival, isn't it? So that time they wear that sari. They prepare the jeera water to drink. When we are drinking water, we drink the plain water, but in Kerala they drink jeera water over there. So each and every custom is different, means every state has some different cultures and customs, isn't it? Then what they do the boat race. The same way we also in Karnataka also there are many culture and customs. Can anybody just name some, as I told you about Kerala? Okay, I'll tell about Maharashtra also. There people wear Navari. Gudi Padwa is celebrated everywhere, even in Karnataka. It is called as Yugadi. Isn't it? So our Karnataka also has some customs and culture. So this will be your homework. What you do as I'm talking about the customs and culture of Uttarakhand, this will be a homework for you all to know, to know the culture of Karnataka also. So this is your homework. When we will be meeting in the next class, that time I want you all to tell me the culture and customs of Karnataka. Okay, so you'll find out the culture and customs of Karnataka. Now we will see about the Uttarakhand as we are learning. So Uttarakhand is a home of multiple ethnic groups. Now, which there they have many different cultures. Now, can you see where is Uttarakhand? Here. See, it has been marked in brown color. Can you see this Uttarakhand? Yes, here is Uttarakhand. It is nearer to Jammu and Kashmir and all. See that? Can you see? So there, as it is nearer to Jammu and Kashmir, what you can what type of weather must be there? Can anybody just tell or just think about that? कैसा वेदर होगा वहां पे? इट विल बी कोल्ड, देयर विल बी स्नो फॉल ओवर देयर इन उत्तराखंड. यस, सो इट इज द 27th स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया. उत्तराखंड इज द 27th स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया. इन जनवरी 2007 द न्यू स्टेट चेंज इट्स नेम टू उत्तराखंड. फर्स्ट इट वॉज नेम्ड एज Arunachal. Then it was by the BJP government. What happened? They changed the name to that, to Uttarakhand. The northern region is also known for the worshipping. Now, what is this worshipping and all? I will tell you. Now, the 27th state of Republic of India, Devbhoomi Uttarakhand. Why it is called as Devbhoomi? Can anybody just tell me? By the name only you can understand. Devbhoomi. No, Devbhoomi means there are lots and lots of temples over there. There are Char Dham Yatra. You must have heard Char Dham Yatra, Gangotri, Kedarnath, Badrinath, and all. हाँ, तो दैट चारधाम यात्रा इज इन एक्चुअली इन उत्तराखंड ओनली. सो इट्स कॉल्ड एज देवभूमि. मींस देयर आर लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ गॉड्स इन उत्तराखंड, एस्पेशली भोलेनाथ, दैट इज महादेव. वहां पे केदारनाथ बहुत लोगों ने सुना होगा. मींस यू मस्ट हैव सी वॉच द मूवी केदारनाथ. इट्स ब्यूटिफुल. He has gone to Kedarnath. So you can ask him how beautiful the weather, the valleys. Badrinath, okay. So that was being formed in 2000 after being separated from the large state of Uttar Pradesh. It is a destination to explore the riches of Indian culture, history, and natural beauty. So, this Uttarakhand, the state was first named as Uttaranchal by Bharatiya Janata Party, that is BJP. Then it led to central government and Uttar Pradesh state government when they started a fresh round of state organization in 1998. However, in 2006, Union Cabinet of India to the agreed to the demands of Uttaranchal Legislative Assembly and leading members of Uttarakhand. So the statehood movement and renamed the Uttaranchal as Uttarakhand. मतलब पहले वो उत्तरांचल था, उसके बाद में उसको उत्तराखंड कर दिया. Now, what is the capital city of Uttarakhand? Can anybody just tell me? Yes, it is Dehradun. The capital city of Uttarakhand is Dehradun. As we have our capital, what is the capital of city of Karnataka? Bangalore. Bangalore. Not Bangalore, it's Bangalore. So, Bangalore. Now you don't call as Belgaum. It is changed to No, what? Belagavi, yes, it is Belagavi. Yeah. Can you see the temple over here? Now, anybody can tell me which temple is this? Yes, it is Kedarnath. As you can see, this is Kedarnath. So, which lord is there in this temple? Shiv, that is our Bholenath. So many of the many of the people want to go to Kedarnath because it is very beautiful, and even though it is beautiful, everybody has that one thing that they want to meet their Lord Shiva. So it is a beautiful temple, and there is a movie also, Kedarnath, which has been who is this? Please, can you just mute yourself, children? Please mute yourself, okay? So there is Kedarnath, which is this? Which temple is this? Yes, it is Gangotri. Now, what is Gangotri? The name itself tells you about Gangotri. So there is, yes. Yes. So yahan pe rivers jo hai. You can see the river flowing over here. There are many rivers also in Uttarakhand. So Uttarakhand state has been divided into two divisions, which are further divided into 13 districts. Okay. So Uttarakhand has totally 13 districts. Then Dehradun is the capital city of Uttarakhand, and it is the biggest city also. It is also known as the land of gods. Why it is called as the land of gods? As I told you, Dev Bhumi. Yes. Okay. I really didn't know about this. Okay. Now there is Rishikesh. Okay, there. So in Rishikesh, the yoga capital of the world, it is known as yoga capital of the world. Rishikesh is also known as yoga capital of world because there yoga jo hai wo bahut hota hai. Next, we will come to the traditional culture of Uttarakhand. Now, you can see the perfect pictures over there, isn't it? So, there are 13 districts separated into two sides of precise Kumaon region and Garhwal district. And individuals of area follows the Garhwali and Kumaon culture. Now, there are two divisions. Now, this Uttarakhand also has many different festivals, their own dressing styles. Can you see this dressing style over here? This is the traditional dress of Uttarakhand. What it has? It has a blouse, odni, and see the jewelries, how beautifully they are dressed up. And whereas when they have weddings and special occasions that time, these women are seen wearing these attractive rangwali pehra, means these all things they wear for their festivals and weddings and all. And you know, as we all, whenever we go for a wedding, even we wear saris and ghagra cholis and all. But they have this typical thing where they wear and they go. So, in Uttarakhand, as we have some arts and crafts, even in Uttarakhand, there you can see the bamboo trees is there now. With that, they prepare these type of baskets and all. They are made by hand. They even knit. Knitting is there. These women, they know knitting very well, and embroidery things also. So whenever you go to Uttarakhand or any of that side of things, you'll get very good shawls, and then sweaters, then socks, hand gloves, caps, and all, which are made by hand, which are all handmade crafts and all. So, children, do you know? Do you want to know again more anything of Uttarakhand? Yes, children. Now I'll tell you one more thing. The food of Uttarakhand is very tasty actually. They have lots and lots of varieties of food. As we, whenever we have festivals, how we prepare Puran Poli is there, and then we prepare all types of kheers and all. It's in the same way, when you go to Uttarakhand, you will see the things which they make with the sweets and all, that is Bal Mithai is there, Singhori is there, Anar is there. So these are some of the sweets which they prepare. They even prepare kheer also. They prepare more of the dals like Urid Dal, Masoor Dal, Chana Dal. All dals they prepare, and they have beautiful utensils also in which they prepare. So this was all about the Uttarakhand.